Voiceover. When a voice, often that of a character in the film, is heard while we see an image of a space and time in which that character is not actually speaking. The versatile nature of voiceover has allowed for its successful use across a wide variety of genres, including...
It always makes me laugh. Andy Dufresne.
Drama.
90% of the living space for life on our planet is in the oceans.
Documentary.
I live in the American Gardens building on West 81st Street, on the 11th floor.
Horror.
Scott is acutely aware that his last salon haircut took place exactly 431 days ago.
And comedy. Yet despite the many potential applications for voiceover narration, Yale Film Analysis describes the technique as often abused, suggesting that over-dependence on voiceover is a telling signal of a director's lack of creativity. I believe that Alfonso Cuarón's Y tu mamá también exemplifies impactful and appropriate voiceover use. Here the device is inseparable from the story being told, but is also used for three very specific purposes outside of the delivery of the narrative. Voiceover is used to make us aware of the underlying class struggle in Mexico, it's used to foreshadow events and force us to reconsider our understanding of the characters, and it's used to tell stories of the people and places that exist on the outskirts of Julio Antonoche's narrow perspective. Firstly, the narrator interrupts a scene of dialogue between Luisa, Tenoch, and Julio, in which Tenoch and Julio are demonstrating the closeness of their bond by sharing intimate stories of one another.
Entre lo mucho que olvidaron mencionar, fue como Julio prendía cerillos para esconder el olor cuando iba al baño en casa de Tenoch, o como Tenoch levantaba con el pie el asiento del excusado en casa de Julio. Esos eran detalles que no tenían por qué saber el uno del otro.
The voiceover's immediate contradiction of the information we just obtained from the characters creates a contrast that highlights the underlying class differences which mediate Julio and Tenoch's relationship, despite their superficial claims. In this next example, we see voiceover used to foreshadow Luisa's eventual passing due to cancer, and to challenge what we think we know about her character up until this point.
Julio y Tenoch pensaban que Luisa estaba dormida. Ignoraban que el miedo se lo impedía. Era un miedo que nada tenía que ver con la oscuridad o con lo que la rodeaba.
The tension generated through voiceover here is a perfect example of its effective implementation. With foresight from the filmmakers, the technique makes Luisa's character more compelling to viewers, as we naturally want to understand the reason for her fear. This idea is set up in advance by a section of voiceover that briefly mentions Luisa receiving the results of an unknown medical test.
No acudía a su encuentro de becarios. Luisa fue al médico a recoger los resultados de unos estudios.
After this brief mention, the narrator quickly moves on to focus on a magazine quiz Luisa completes in the waiting room. This leaves us as much in the dark about Luisa's condition as the two boys, further immersing us in the story and elevating the impact of the revelation of her death at the end of the film. Finally, and in a way that makes its execution in Y tu mamá también so successful, voiceover narration gives us insight into the various tragedies of reality that occur on the outskirts of Julio and Tenoch's narrow perspectives. Here, the pair laugh and lightheartedly blame political protests for the traffic they're stuck in.
Ese mismo día hubo tres manifestaciones en distintos lugares de la ciudad. Sin embargo, el embotellamiento que los detenía había sido provocado por un peatón atropellado. Marcelino Escutia, un albañil inmigrado de Michoacán.
It's not until the narrator attributes the traffic jam to the death of a pedestrian that we realize the stark contrast between the boy's perception of the world and the harsh reality of it. The narration is key here in making the environment an important element of the story without diminishing the significance of the events in Julio and Tenoch's lives. The director, Alfonso Cuarón, was acutely aware of this throughout the filmmaking process.
With tu mama también, we started this thing of doing, giving as much importance to the foreground as to the background, meaning mm-hmm. as much importance to the character yeah. as to the social environment that surrounds the characters. Right.
In this interview, Cuarón suggests that he and his brother approached the concept of Y tu mamá también with the intention of using voiceover narration to connect the primary narrative of Julio and Tenoch's coming-of-age story to the larger background story, which is that of Mexico's volatile socio-political environment. Scholars appear to be undecided about what exactly makes an application of voiceover successful, but I believe that in the case of Y tu mamá también, The director's unique vision couldn't have been executed in any other way. The device allows Cuarón to make us aware of the underlying class struggle in Mexico, whilst foreshadowing events and challenging our understanding of the main characters, and telling stories of the people and places that exist outside of the primary narrative. Together, these applications work to engage us in the world of the film, beyond any of the primary characters or narratives, making Y Tu Mama Tambien so easy to connect with, and its use of voiceover so successful.